In today's class, we are going to study about the geometrical representation of a zero of a polynomial. Suppose f(x) is a polynomial and f(x) is equal to ax plus b. In place of f(x), we can write y. So we can say that y is equal to ax plus b. Now we will study the geometrical meaning or geometrical representation of zero of a polynomial. It can be the polynomial. It can be linear, quadratic, cubic, bi-quadratic, etc. So for y equal to ax plus b, suppose x equal to k is the zero of the polynomial. Now we, in place of x, if we put k, so we get a k plus b equal to zero. Now k is equal to minus b by a. Now it can be represented in geometrical form like the line represented by the black colored line. It is y equal to ax plus b. It intersects x axis at minus b by a. Now since y is equal to 0, so the coordinates of p is minus b by a comma 0. So at x equal to k, that is minus b by a, the line graph will cut x axis or intersect x axis. So if it is a linear graph, it cuts at one place or it intersects x in one place. So what is the type of polynomial and how many times it intersect? Number of times it intersects the x-axis, there is a relationship between them. Now we will study this relationship. So if the polynomial is linear, it will intersect the x-axis one time. For linear polynomial, that is like in the previous example we have seen that y equal to ax plus b, it is a linear polynomial. So for linear polynomial, the number of times it intersects x axis is 1. For quadratic polynomial, the number of times it intersects x axis is 2. For cubic polynomial, the number of times the graph will intersect x axis will be 3. For biquadratic polynomial, the number of times the graph will intersect x axis is 4. Now we see an example, y equal to 3x plus 4. Putting y equal to 0, we can find the zero of the polynomial. So 3x plus 4 is equal to 0. 3x is equal to minus 4. So x is equal to minus 3 by 4. Now we will see the graph of this line, y equal to 3x plus 4. Now we can say that this graph will intersect the x axis at minus 4 by 3. So the point of intersection will be minus 4 by 3 and 0. Now we will study about how to find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. For example, y equal to x square minus 3x minus 4. So what we see that if the product of x square and minus 4 is negative, then the middle term will be brought by subtracting. So we can write y equal to x square minus 4x minus x minus 4. Now we can see that y is equal to x plus 1 and into x minus 4. So if we put y equal to 0, we get the roots or the zeros at x equal to minus 1 and x equal to 4. Now we know that the graph of quadratic polynomial is a parabola. So it will intersect x axis at minus 1 and 4. So like we have seen that the quadratic polynomial, for the quadratic polynomial, it intersects the x-axis in two points. So you can see in the graph, it intersects the x-axis at minus 1 and 4. So now we can see other examples. Find the number of, in these examples, we have to find the number of zeros of polynomial Px. So this is the first graph, Px. This graph is a straight line, it intersects the x-axis at no points, so number of zeros is 0. Now another example, in this case number of zeros is 1 because it intersects the x-axis at one point. Another example, see the graph, we can see that the graph is intersecting x-axis at 3 points, so number of zeros will be 3. Another example, we can see in the graph that the graph is intersecting x-axis in two points. So if the like number of zeros is zero, then it will be a constant polynomial. So now in this example, number of zeros is 2. Another example, in this graph you can see that the graph is intersecting x-axis at 4 different points. So number of zeros is clearly 4. Another example, you can see that the graph has cut at one point and touched at another point, and it is going to touch at another point. So the graph is intersecting x-axis at 3 different points. So number of zeros is 3.